Salut tout le monde, on est reparti sur Control.
Again, a welcome message.
Thank you. look at it. 8 inches wide and capable of storing a whopping 80 kilobytes. Stolen by our friends at the CIA, the disk held the launch codes to Soviet nukes. This is not the disk, of course, but one exactly like it, a perfect fusion of concepts vibrating in the Cold War era collective unconscious. A receptacle. It is a receptacle for dangerous energies to hone in on, and they did. We don't have the details, but when things started flying around the disk, it was transferred to us. It's an object of power. OOP. Oops. Oh, and it can launch things telekinetically through the air. To date, we've launched maybe 3 dozen pencils. And once, we even launched a cup.
Communications. We're on the right track.
Look at it. 8 inches wide and capable.
Object of power. Looks like the hiss flashed onto it. We need to cleanse it. It's harder to hear you when I'm here. It's like the channel's been changed. The boards in charge here, their pyramids in the Bureau seal. Are they really the ones pulling the strings? I'm not their director. I'm no one's director. You were gone. Cut off. I got it. Joseph. Emily said that the hotline can be reached through the mail. This must open the door.
Listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years. Thank you for staying up with us. Ghosts. We've had many callers over the years tell us of hauntings, voices, and
Thank you.
You're listening to America.
have a feeling he'll be back. Let's stay focused. The hotline should be past the mailroom.
All right, take this down. The situation in Cuba has been evaluated by the relevant authorities.
Alberto Tomasi, head of comms.
Affecting the staff at the U.S. Embassy in Havana was
caused
by sonic weaponry in the hands of a foreign power. Numerous personnel have damage to the inner ear, but most are expected to make a full recovery. Of course, the event also damaged their cellular walls, but we can't blame that on some stupid noise gun. Thank God no local doctors examined them first. Honestly, what are the odds an alternate item would show up inside a U.S. embassy? Talk about good luck, huh? So much easier than... Hey, are you still recording this?
The hotline can't be far now.
Ocean View Motel and Casino. Green logic. The light switch cord. Door marked with a black pyramid.
Whoa! Have we been here before? No. I've stayed at a lot of roadside motels across the country, on the road, on the run, under the radar. This feels like all of them, like something recognized from a dream.
Hello? Anyone here?
Key has a black pyramid on it.
Thank you.
It is a phone. It's an object of power. It doesn't connect to any typical network. A direct line to the astral plane and the board. And my hypothesis is, under the right conditions, to other planes of existence as well.
A director needs a team. My management team. These people know the secrets of the Bureau as well as I do. Some even better. Darling, Tomasi, Salvador, Marshall. Marshall especially, my head of operations. She sees right through me. She knows I don't like relying on people. The only person you should fail is yourself. But things change when you become director.
I have it. The hotline. I can reach Trench. Well, listen to him. He feels more like an echo. An echo with important. I need to get back to Emily. People react strongly when I tell them about you. Is it too soon to tell Emily? She might be able to help.
Jesse, did you get the hotline? I mean, how is it out there? The comms? The hiss? Sorry. You made it. I'm glad.
Emily? Let's talk. I got the hotline. I can make out what Trench is saying now.
Incredible. What did he say?
He talked about his management team. People who knew the Bureau's secrets. Your boss, Darling. Tomasi, but he's gone. The hiss gone. Salvador?
He's the head of security.
And Marshall?
Helen Marshall is head of operations. She's tough, ex-CIA. She took her Rangers and went to the research sector to secure the HRA production. She hasn't come back.
Someone who could help us. The other sectors. How do I get there?
It's impossible because of the internal lockdown. You can perform a directorial override to lift it, but that can only be done in the maintenance sector. Normally, you take the sector elevator down there. It connects all the sectors, but it won't work while the lockdown is in effect.
We already got past one lockdown.
Maybe I can find a way. Jesse, look, with no prep, no training, in this extreme situation, you are doing phenomenally well. And all that in the Hiss can't seem to affect you. I mean, I would love to run some tests on you. If you agree, that is. We could find out something that would help us.
Tests? I don't know. She might find out about you. But I wouldn't mind understanding more myself.
Okay. If you think it will help.
Great. I'll check the internal documentation for any lockdown bypasses. We need to get these sectors open to locate Darling and Marshall.
And I'll look for a way inside the maintenance sector. The sooner we find one, the sooner I reach this override.
Do you hear that? Someone's singing.
Singing?
Where's it coming from?
Sounds like it's coming from the elevator.
They say the new director can launch objects up to 20 feet.
Bullshit. You never...
Reporting any distance over 5.
Obviously, you never read the P6 data. Questions could be answered by obtaining the hypothesis.
Reminder, if you experience an unanticipated building shift,
has asked us to document the hiss incantation, as she calls it.
time to work. Meet me in the main Denanos.
Like I said before, the janitor is a friendly face. The maintenance sector is the janitor domain. If I can find Ati here, he can help me reach the override. Maybe it was you who got me into the oldest house with the lockdown on. Maybe it was Ati. It felt like he made the elevator appear that took me to Trench's office. Is Ati guiding me too? The directorial override is right there, in the control room. How do we get there? Down that way.
Well done. You got the job. It's place for congratulations. Yippee, Satana. It happened in the last drop. I truly need an assistant.
Funny thing is, I've been a janitor. I'm more at home in that role than as the director. Only Ati here seems to see that.
Yeah, hi, Ati. Look, we need to get the lockdown lifted, otherwise I can't get to the other sectors. Can you help me get to the override?
Yes, yes. Easy peasy. It's just around the corner. But first, we need to get you working. Very small couple of hours job.
Something tells me it's gonna be more than that.
You think there's a dog buried in this? I can tell you are not yesterday's Krause's son. That's why you'll make a great assistant. Very well. I'll hit the facts on the table. I'm gonna sanon perkele suoraan, that this house has a vermin problem. A bad one. They've already messed up the cooling pumps. And the power generators of a power plant, perkele. And the pensioner inside is starting to feel the band around his head tighten. The situation needs to be fixed before the plant blows up. And we all disappear like a fart in Sahara.
Trying my best to keep up with this. Fix the coolant pumps and the power generators, otherwise the power plant will blow.
But don't you worry. I've left you clear instructions. You'll catch the end of the thread before I go to my vacation. The works on the task board here, you can do later, when you have time.
Vacation? Right.
Yes, no one's gonna cancel my holiday or seats gonna rattle. But don't worry at all. You'll take care of it and soon this crisis gonna be last winter snow. You better go now, so you don't have to run with your head as your third leg. The door in the back leads to the plant.
The door in the back. That's great. Thank you, Ati.
Yep. The dress. Throw it in the fire. Burn it all. Burn it in the rain.
Yeah.
Ugh, this place makes me nauseous. An object of power. How do you think it got down here? A carousel horse. Why is kid stuff always so creepy?
Stepping to the FBC, there's lots to do, there's lots to be, but look, don't dash, and don't scream much, let's join the Thresher Kids, let's join the Thresher Kids.
Okay, so what happens again if that thing blows up?
Thank you.
talk with Chief Arish in the security booth. He's in charge here.
Chief Arish, FBC Security. Shouldn't you be in a safe room?
HRAs. We're on the same side.
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm here to perform the directorial override to get the lockdown lifted.
Yeah. Chief Arish, FBC Security. I'm just... Oh, hang on. You're the new director. It's a pleasure, ma'am.
Let's skip the formalities, please.
Right. Faden, ma'am. Look, as you can probably tell, it's a bit of a shit show down here. We've been holding our ground, but... whatever's gotten into our buddies has them wrecking the coolant pumps and the power converters. The NSC keeps overheating, and my crews keep getting shot before they have a chance to make any repairs.
NSC?
Oh, sorry. Bureau jargon. It's what we call the power plant. You know, the big rumbling metal thing? Salvador, head of security, asked me to protect it in case of an attack. See, what's inside is dangerous. Dr. Darling seemed to know it would be a target.
Darling? He's here?
No, he came down a few days ago, before everything went to hell. He was out of it. Smelled like a bar mat. He was ranting about vulnerabilities and how he only had one large-scale HRA, but that he needed it somewhere else. Still, at least he gave us these personal HRAs before he left. Hey, did I mention that he was tearing his clothes off? Crazy dude.
Darling knew the hiss was coming.
Listen, I love playing 20 questions as much as the next guy, but we have got to get the water and electrical systems repaired before this baby blows. I'll have my guys unlock the doors out of here for you.
I'll take care of it. You stay and keep the hiss away from the plant if you can.
The hiss? That's what we're calling him? Well, that's catchy. Listen, the radios aren't working, so if you find my boss Salvador out there, could you please ask him what the plan is? I'm sure he will have one by now.
I'll keep an eye out for him.
He sure has a lot of faith in his boss.
Try to stay alive.
Thank you. Not that sound.
So I just read this. Welcome to the Ranger Field Training Course. The course must be completed in this specified amount of time. When you're ready to start, press the button. Is that all, or?
I always did love obstacle courses.
Get ready, Ranger. Course starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Course failed. Try again, Ranger.
Shit!
Ready, Ranger. Course starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. 45 seconds remaining. Seconds remaining. 15 seconds remaining. Force failed. Try again, Ranger. Get ready, Ranger. Force starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Seconds remaining. Course complete. Congratulations, Rainier.
Guessing this isn't over.
The course.
It's protecting itself. Shield.
Thank you.
It's fried up. You need to fix it before all the victims inside the plant has a ship.
Pumps and water flow.
power cut. Replace the parts.
Oh, this place is gonna come down. We need to fix this thing ASAP.
Fix it fast. If the plant goes poo, we can throw the spoon in the corn. My old enemy, the Glock, is blocking the pipes. We need to be here. He is very clever. He's trying to sneak in. He caught
what
him caught with his
that?
Hand in the fish trap.
That's the most disgusting thing I've ever seen. Hold together a little longer. Let's go lift the lock.
pipes see through... Eh? When the converters and coolant pumps are working again, we should be able to get this baby back down to a safe temperature. I hope.
I should be going. Try to stay alive.
Right. You got a lockdown to lift. What's your read on this? Thank you.
Did Ati mean barrels full of hazardous biological material? Seems like I'm breaking some environmental regulations and waste disposal. But that's what Ati wants. And I'll get it done.
My name is Dr. Pierce, lead researcher. Paranatural entity residing within the Bureau itself. Right under our noses. Darling refused to allocate me the budget or resources, so I'm taking matters into my own hands. Let this recording be the proof I need to convince them. The furnace can speak. It's been talking to me for some time now. Listen. Volunteers.
Thank you.
Thank you.